I wonder if you've ever heard of neurofibromatosis. I must confess that until recently I hadn't, despite working in pharmaceutical research for over 25 years. Neurofibromatosis, or NF for short, is a genetic disorder that causes tumours to grow on nerves anywhere in the body, including the brain and the spinal cord. It can lead to blindness, deafness, chronic pain, and a whole host of other complications and disabilities. And yet, it's actually one of the more common neurogenetic diseases, affecting one in every 3,000 births. And yet it's still widely unknown compared with other diseases that you might well have heard of, such as Huntington's disease or cystic fibrosis. It can affect people of all ethnicities, and actually half of all cases occur in families with no history of the disorder. So anyone's next child could be affected by NF. Currently, there is no cure or effective treatment for NF, but it's our pleasure and privilege today to be welcoming a family that is helping to change all of that. We're joined by Jake and Beth Burke, together with their son Jack, who was diagnosed with NF in 2011, and their other children, Luke and Grace. And they've founded an organisation called Cure NF with Jack. And today we're going to hear something of their journey together as a family. So, let's start with the important things. Jack, what's your favourite movie of all time?
That is actually so hard. I can't say favourite movie because they're great. Every new movie can be great. Every old movie is great. So I really can't.
It's a tough question,
yeah,
isn't it?
It's tough, yeah.
And what else do you like to do when you're not busy with your schoolwork?
I like to hang out with my friends. I'm in the Boy Scouts.
Okay.
So I like to camp. Yeah.
Fantastic. And we've got your brother and sister here, yeah. Luke and Grace, and it's great to see you two as well.
Thank you.
It must be tough sometimes having a brother with NF. So what's the worst thing about it for you guys?
Dad, he can't be a normal kid. You know? Like, he gets tired a lot.
Yeah.
And that just makes him miss out on a lot of stuff.
Right.
So,
how about you, Luke?
Yeah, more like what she said, but like to see him suffering, like through surgeries and stuff like that, numerous doctor's appointments. It, like, not many people go through that, and that kind of stinks to see someone have to go through that.
Mm. And what are you trying to do along with the rest of the family to help?
Make a cure for NF.
Right.
Make some money.
So it's a real family effort,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, like raise money for. In like golf tournaments or poker tournaments or anything like that.
Brilliant. Jake and Beth, could you perhaps tell us briefly about how Jack came to be diagnosed with NF?
Well, we were actually visiting our family in Atlanta. Mm-hmm. Luke was just born and Jack had an ear infection and we took him to the local pediatrician and you know, in the past, our local pediatrician in D.C. had just said, does anybody in your family have neural long name? That's what we called it.
Right.
We'd say no, and it would the subject would be dropped.
Right.
But when we went in for this, sick appointment when he was two, the doctor kind of stopped us, saw his cafe au lait spots, and said, if it were my child, I would go to a specialist and get it checked out. He could have neurofibromatosis.
Right.
I thought that the physician, when she told us that, she saw the look on our face and realized that we really didn't know.
Mm.
And she, kind of as a human being, I could just, in thinking back about that, she kind of pulled back a little bit and said, it might not be that,
right,
let's understand that. But of course, Beth and I left that office and did what you're not supposed to do that night.
Right.
And go onto the internet where everything is doom and gloom.
Yes.
But immediately started that evening, quite frankly, we reached out to who was perhaps one of the most well-known physicians in the NF world, is Bruce Korff.
Mm-hmm.
And I emailed him at about 2 in the morning, not thinking I'd ever hear from him at all, maybe again. And within 2 hours, at 4 in the morning, I got a response back from him saying, let's get together and find out. So
that's incredible, isn't it?
Yeah, and I think in short, we learned the hard way that 50% of the cases are spontaneous mutation.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That was a long day.
I bet it was, yeah. So one of the features, as I was trying to mention in the introduction, is that you can get tumors anywhere. And how has that affected Jack?
Well, I have one on my eye, which affects my sight, so right. I need to wear glasses.
Okay.
I have one on my, small one on my back. It doesn't really affect me that much, but, you know, it's still there.
Mm.
And I have one on my brainstem.
Right.
A glioma. I had to get surgery for that, but the way it affects me is I get headaches easier.
Okay, yeah. Right. And how was that surgery for you? How did it work out?
Well, it was 4 years ago. The first few days were terrible. I wasn't awake at all. I was in pain. I just slept for the whole time.
Right.
But after the week went by, I started to get better and better. And after 4 weeks, I was back at school all
Amazing.
Better.
Yeah.
The tumor itself, the glioma, is inoperable. So you did have to undergo a year of 52 weeks of chemotherapy.
Right, yes.
The brain surgery itself was just to release pressure on his spine. He had developed a syrinx. Yeah.
52 weeks of chemo, and he just forgot to mention that.
That's just
how tough he is. David is. I had to do that too. That's pretty. It's pretty amazing.
It is absolutely.
Yeah.
This is a kind of no-brainer question in a way, but what motivated you to start Cure NF with Jack?
Well,
we could go.
I was only six when they started that, so I don't remember much about starting it. But I remember them going, "Hey, Jack, for your NF, we're going to raise money for it and give it to scientists to help cure it, and we're going to have a golf tournament." Mm-hmm. I'm like, "Oh, cool," you know. And the money goes not to me, but to everybody with NF. Like, it goes to scientists and research to help fund clinical trials and help fund new ways scientists can find a cure.
Yeah, and I was just born when you started the tournaments, right?
That's right. And yeah. I think, more specifically, I mean, Jake and I will never forget the night that we figured out that he has neurofibromatosis, and it brought us to our knees quite literally. And we kept it close to the vest for a little while because we didn't know what it was, and it was hard to find information about it. But I think we soon realized that for us, that the only way to help our feelings of helplessness and hopelessness was to do our part to find a cure.
Yeah. And how much have you raised to date?
How much have I raised? About over $3 million. So
that's fantastic.
A lot, yeah.
That's great.
I'm very happy.
There you are, that's fantastic.
Yeah. Again, it's just all the support that we get, David. We had a goal in mind when we started. He was 6 years old, and we thought that by the time he graduated high school, we could raise $1 million and have impact. And we did that in 5 years. We're just going to do our best to continue.
Sounds like
to do
it's
that.
Accelerating, actually.
Yeah, yeah, it's wonderful. It really is.
And I was interested in the logo for the organization. You've got a four-leaf clover, is that right, isn't it? And what's the significance of that?
Well, I am very Irish.
So
that is the reason why. And also, it means good luck,
That's
too.
That's right, yeah.
So, you know, good luck with the cure.
Okay, fantastic. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Yeah,
it does.
And you mentioned some of the clinical research that's going on. And obviously, as a scientist, you know, that's really interesting to me. So could you tell a little bit about, perhaps, I don't know, is there some gene therapy being explored?
There are a couple of things that are going on that are really exciting for us. On the gene therapy side, to date there's been, you know, no therapy, let alone no real substantial research in that arena to address the underlying cause of NF. That is until now. The Gilbert Family Foundation had an award go out in December of 2018, so just, you know, nine months ago.
Yeah.
It's a $12 million three-year study with nine teams of 30-plus researchers and you know, going to the cause, different areas of interest within that realm. On the other side of things, we have two drugs that are currently hopefully going to get FDA approval for the treatment of plexiform neurofibroma as a chemotherapy. So it's very big for us.
Yeah, absolutely. And are these existing compounds that have been repurposed for this? Do you know, is that?
Well, the one was co-developed by, selumetinib was co-developed by AstraZeneca and Merck. And that is on the final stages of FDA approval. We're crossing our fingers. It's a breakthrough status right now. And then the other one, mirdametinib, was developed by SpringWorks Therapeutics. And both of those were in collaboration with the Children's Tumor Foundation, who's done tremendous, tremendous work in our world. And that is also like on the late stages.
So if we came back this time next year.
We're hoping that we're going to say we've got an approved drug for sure. Yeah.
And when we think about that, just, you know, 10 years ago, when we were starting this journey, and there wasn't anything, to our knowledge, close to that, what I'm hopeful for is kind of like the trend line with Cure and F with Jack.
Yeah.
The trend line for treatment and cures and research is going to go the same way, so that, in fact, next year and the year after that, there's going to be new news all the time.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Well, thanks ever so much, all of you, for joining us today.
Thank you, David.
While you're here in Boston, have you got any fun plans?
Well, we are actually leaving back. We're going back home tonight.
Tonight, okay.
But we stayed with our family over the weekend. We got here on Friday. We got to see our cousins.
Okay.
We got to go out to a Paul Bear restaurant, which is a really good diner.
Right.
we stayed at our grandma's house.
Fantastic.
So that was fun.
And we also went to Duncan's.
Duncan's, it's always a high point, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, and Mom is actually staying here another day, so she'll get back to Atlanta tomorrow.
Okay, that's right. Right. Well, I might see you at the airport because I'm flying home tomorrow evening as well. Anyway, it's been lovely to meet you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, David.
Thank you. Thank you.